Coming to you from this beautiful property at 17 Elm Street, Blackburn, welcome to another Noel Jones Monthly Market Update.
Well, you may have heard there's a lack of stock on the market at the moment, and that's certainly been demonstrated with some of the results that have come through in the last month. First one I want to talk about was number 22 Sussex Street in Blackburn North, just on the fringe of the Blackburn area we find ourselves in today. That one sold for $1,070,000, which was pretty big money for a property that was a land value sale, 635 square metres. And the new owners are looking at putting a Porter Davis home on that site in the not too distant future. Speaking of Porter Davis homes, we also sold the property at number 5 Edwin Street in Box Hill North, which went to auction. There was some good interest in the property just over the $2 million mark, 2.1, that sort of range. We finally sold it for $2.195 million 2 weeks after the auction, which was well worth the wait. A beautiful Porter Davis home, very well specced up with a nice in-ground pool, lovely family home, which I'm sure the new owners will enjoy. And finally, we sold number 7 Linden Street in Blackburn, one of the leafy tree-lined streets in this neighbourhood as well. A great sale there, 6 people bidding for that particular property, some looking at the land value, others looking at retaining the home that was there. Sold under very competitive conditions, and that one went for $1.3 million.
The first new listing we're going to talk about today is 17 Elm Street in Blackburn, which we're in currently. This is a 4-bedroom new house, backing onto a park, just over 700 square metres of land, and a fantastic one for new families looking to get into the area. Having just walked into the property and seen it myself, this is a must-see property. Another new listing we've got is 25 Blackburn Road in Blackburn. This one has 6 dwellings on the site. These units are all priced around the $600,000 and are off the plan. So anyone looking to get in and save a bit on stamp duty, certainly come and see us about these ones. And finally, we've got 2 Glenis Avenue in Blackburn South. This property is on just over 490 square metres of land. Be fantastic for an investor, someone looking to get into the market, or possibly downsizing. Campaign on this one is just starting now.
Paul, with a lot of changes recently in real estate, one being technology, how have you seen that affect the market?
Well, you're right, Jack. Technology has been one of the biggest changes in the industry over the last few years in particular. We've seen buyers particularly demanding a lot more information, and I think through the internet, certainly promotional videos, both by agents and properties, the information is much more accessible to the buyers, and they're coming to our properties and auctions, I think, a better armed and with more information that allows them to bid more freely and perhaps bid with more confidence. One of the other things, Jack, that we're using really well at the moment, getting some great feedback, is of Instagram and Facebook. Yep. The numbers using those mediums have been fantastic. It's really keeping the buyers up to date and informative. We're doing live auctions now. We're promoting properties instantly on Facebook, and that's keeping buyers up to date, as I said, and no doubt helping them with their purchasing decisions.
In particular, have you noticed any products that we're using that have really assisted in this process?
Oh, absolutely. We are currently using what's called a webbook, and a webbook is a summary of all the information relevant to the property. So some of the feedback from buyers over the last few months and certainly a few years is that agents never get back to them, and they're left wondering about some information that they've requested. So we have a response now within about 3 to 4 minutes of every email inquiry. They get a response that gives them all the information they need, and then of course we're able to follow that up with a phone call. So buyers won't tolerate any more being waiting for 3 to 4 days waiting for information, and that certainly has helped the industry as a whole.
Well, we hope you found that helpful, and if you're looking to sell your home before Christmas, now's the time to call us. We'll see you next time.